Hey, what up? It's Woolmaker. Today I'm going to do a walkthrough in Ableton. So if this is your first DAW or you're just making a switch, I'll go ahead and help you get started. So let's go ahead and jump in. The first thing I'm going to briefly do is go over setup. So you go to live, you go to the setting preferences. Under the audio tab, you have your inputs and outputs. This is where you can select your interface if it's plugged in, computer speakers, or using headphones. The next thing that I'll briefly go over is latency. Latency is an annoying delay in your audio. To help you with that, go to the buffer size. This is the amount of time it takes for your computer to process the audio. If you're mixing, I recommend using a higher buffer size. When recording with the mic and headphones, use a lower buffer size. You can also go to the look and feel tab, and you can choose the light and dark mode. Now, over here on the left-hand side, under categories, you have your instruments, which is where you're going to find your samplers, empty drum racks, and other tools. Your stock sounds will be in sounds. This has your piano, synth keys, and all other sounds to play out and make beats. You also have a bunch of drum kits under drums. You have your audio effects tab, which is where your delays, reverbs, EQs. Your plugins tab is where your third-party plugins are stored. Down below, under places, this is where your personal samples are going to be stored. So now for the good stuff. To load a sample or instrument, you can either double-click it or you can just drag it down here. If you double-click a sample, it defaults into Ableton's stock sampler, which is simpler. You can preview your sounds or samples when the headphone icon is selected. You can set your tempo here, and you can turn on your metronome right here. You also have other options with the metronome as well right here, along with your count-in for the metronome. I like double time, so I'm going to set my tempo at 140 BPMs. You'll also notice that your track has to be armed to hear anything on the track. You have a solo button here, and this is a mute button. If you want a better view of your faders, you can drag right here. Now, what first intrigued me about Ableton were the clips. You can have a verse in one, you can have a bridge in another. This allows me to focus on one section at a time. You can also record in arrangement view like most DAWs, but I prefer to use the clips in session view. You can also toggle between session and arrangement view using the tab button or click up here. You also notice that the clips have these stop and play buttons, and if your track is armed, you also have a record button. So you can stop or play a clip at any time. And if you want to stop the whole session, you can just come up here and hit stop. So we'll go ahead and we'll record some chords into this clip. So once you have something recorded into a clip, you can double click inside the clip and it brings up the piano roll. Now you have access to extend notes, quantize, copy paste notes, etc. You can drag over here to line up your measure. We'll start by highlighting all our notes, which is command A. Now we can quantize our notes, which helps us line up the notes to the grid. We'll start by accessing our settings, which is shift command U. Here we can choose which grid pattern that we want, where we want to adjust the notes, whether it's the start or the end or both, and then the amount. Since I don't want everything perfectly on time sounding robotic, I'll go ahead and I'll choose 56%. Now all I have to do to quantize is hit Command U, and then you can drag and fix notes as you wish. Now I'll go ahead and I'll add some drums. You can bring up a new MIDI track by using Shift Command T. You can add a stock kit, or if you have your own samples, you can use an empty drum rack and add your own. In this example, we're just going to use an Ableton stock kit. And I'm just going to double click the clip and draw in my notes. Here we can set the length. I'll just go ahead and I'll just use 2 bars. Once we have our pattern, we can copy paste by highlighting all of the notes again, or you can just use Command A. Then use Command C to copy. Then insert the cursor where you want to paste and use Command V. And then you'll want to extend your loop tool. Now your grid patterns are down here. The shortcuts to the grid pattern are on the screen. Next, if you want to record an external keyboard or record using a mic, you'll need to use an audio track. Next, you're going to go to the audio from, and you're going to make sure the external in is selected. And then select your input number. A mic is mono, so you want to make sure that you have the correct number on your mic input and not stereo. Otherwise, you'll be recording one side. So you wouldn't want to select 1, 2. You want to select 1, or if your input is in 2, select 2. And as a bonus to help you with latency, when recording vocals, come up here to option and check the reduce latency when monitoring. Ableton also provides you with 12 return tracks. You could put things like delay, reverb, and other effects on these. The letter for your return track is here, and then your send knob is located here. Lastly, you have your arrangement view. I find this another real key feature that Ableton offers. To arrange your track, start by clicking and holding a clip that you'd like to start with, and then use the tab button to place your clip. Now you can copy paste your patterns. You can also duplicate your patterns with Command D. If you look at the top here, you'll notice that this is where your bars are. And if you look at the bottom, this is where your time is. To activate arrangement view, you can click here, or you can use Fn plus F10. You can also set your loop points by highlighting your region and then use Command L. If you want a continuous loop, make sure that the loop is selected. So this is a quick rundown to get you started. If you want all my must-use shortcuts in Ableton, you can find those here. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more content like this. Other than that, peace out.